Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. This is part 17 of my course, The Practical Guide to Mac Security. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to my great group of Patreon supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon to find out more and join us.
One of the most important things that you need to do to protect your Mac, especially if you have a portable Mac, is to turn on Find My. You do that in the iCloud settings and system preferences. So go to Apple ID, go to iCloud, and look for Find My Mac. Now you can only have it turned on for one account on that Mac, which makes sense. After all, it applies to the entire device. So whoever has the primary user account for that Mac, doesn't really matter if you know everybody using the Mac is equal. Just for one of those accounts, have it turned on. In this case, this is my demo account for recording tutorials. So it's not on. It's already in use by my primary account on this Mac. And once you turn it on, now you can find your Mac if it's lost. So you could use the Find My app on another Mac or on an iPhone or iPad, or you could do it on the web on a device that's not even yours. So let's do it here on the Find My app on this Mac. You can see there are three tabs here, People, Devices, and Items. So People would be more for finding individuals that are part of your family sharing or that have shared their location with you. Typically, this is going to use their iPhone, the thing that's always with them. But Devices is where you would go to check all of your devices that are registered to your Apple ID. So if you own a lot of devices, like obviously I do, then they would all be in a list here. So let's say, for instance, you want to locate your MacBook. It's gone missing. You could click on that device here and it will locate it on the map. So now you can see it here. You can click the I button and it will give you some options. You can also control click on it here and you can see some of the options there. Let's click the I button. It's going to show the location of this Mac as best it could figure out. And this can get reported in a variety of different ways. If this was an iPhone, it may be using GPS on the iPhone. But with a MacBook, it may be using other devices around it to figure out where it is and report its location back. If it's still within your control, say it's at another location for you or it's nearby, you could play a sound and the MacBook would play a sound and you can use that to locate it. You could also mark it as lost or erase the device. So when you go to mark it as lost, then you could see here what it's going to do is it's going to lock it. So anybody who has, say, stolen it from you can't access it. And it will also deactivate some critical things like Apple Pay that you don't want to be out there with somebody else maybe being able to get control over. They also can't erase it, meaning that they can't now take it, erase it, and try to resell it. The Mac's locked, so it's useless to them. You could also just choose to erase the device. So if you think it's really gone, you're never getting it back, it's been stolen, you can erase it so your data is protected. So you can see how very useful it is to have this turned on. It's a great security feature. It doesn't cost you anything extra. There's nothing you need to do except make sure it's on all your devices because, of course, once they're lost or stolen, there's nothing you can do to turn it on at that point. So you want to make sure it's turned on so you're ready to use it if you need it. Also note that you can go to iCloud.com. And from there, you can use the Find feature. It's still called Find iPhone. I think at some point they'll just call it Find My or whatever. This allows you to find all of your devices. And you could click here and you could see a list of your devices just as before. And you could do all of the same features that you could do in the Find My app. But the important thing is you could be using somebody else's computer to do this. So if your MacBook is stolen, you can hop on somebody else's computer. You can lock it or erase it from that location. As long as you can log on to your iCloud account, you could do that. Having a device stolen is one of the worst feelings and it makes you feel powerless. There's nothing you could do, but with Find My, you at least get some of that control back. You could either protect your data and you could also protect the device itself to at least make it less valuable to somebody who has stolen your Mac.
If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.